there's no crap on my face. Let's see now. Okay, this is for Monday, the 8th of February, 2021. And I'm Collins. I've come to bother you again because I wanted to talk about those occasions when you say something and the person you're talking to hears the opposite of what you said. This is kind of an extreme example of not quite getting it right. He said, she said. Okay, we're going to talk about Heisenberg and Bohr, right? The early atomic physicists. In September 1941, Werner Heisenberg made a trip to Copenhagen to see Niels Bohr on a special occasion. Now, these guys had been close colleagues and friends since the 1920s. They used to go skiing together, and they, you know, together they were both developing quantum mechanics and modern atomic theory. So these guys were good friends. They were like best friends, but they ended up at the time of the war breaking out with Niels Bohr living a good life in Copenhagen and Heisenberg working for the Germans, essentially. And Heisenberg wanted to get from Bohr some moral advice, I guess you could say, as to whether scientists should or shouldn't work on an atomic weapon if such a thing was possible. He wanted to get Bohr's opinion as to whether it was right for scientists to do that. And I think maybe he was also trying to tip off Niels Bohr that the Germans were engaging in such an effort. At least that's what Heisenberg claims he went there to talk to Bohr about. There's some disagreement about that. Bohr, what he heard was that he heard Heisenberg telling him that Germany was going to win the war by way of nuclear weapons, and that that the Danes ought to just, you know, get on the bandwagon. That's what Niels Bohr thought Heisenberg was trying to tell him. Of course, now, I was not there in Copenhagen in 1941. Nor was I on the moon in 1969. So I don't really know what was said. But I can tell you that there are times when people hear something quite different from what you say. And they can read even something different than what you wrote. And I've had that happen to me a couple of times. Many years ago, I was talking to a good friend, and I happened to, I'm not sure quite what we were discussing, but I mentioned that her long-term relationship seemed to be working out great, because it seemed to me she had a great thing going on. What she heard was that her beloved wanted to break up with her, which was quite far away from what I said, and I wouldn't have said that because I didn't think so. But that was what she was ready to hear because of some sensitivity that she had. And so she thought that I said that, literally. And I had a hell of a time trying to convince her that that's not what I meant or said. So this is an occasion, well, I want to say, this kind of thing is a problem when people try to communicate but don't. I think that's a special case of just misremembering stuff. I mean, anybody can remember a conversation imprecisely, not quite hearing what was said, and maybe it wasn't that important to get it right, and people kind of like, sometimes people hear what they want to hear or what they're ready to hear, or what their minds are preset to hear, and that imprecision can be quite benign sometimes. I mean, you know, whether, oh, I remember you ordered potatoes. Maybe he didn't order potatoes. Like, if somebody's mind is prepared to hear one thing, they might not hear the other thing. And if they hear exactly the opposite of what you're trying to say, then this can have damaging impact on truth. And it has implications for history as well. There's also the factor of preferential narrative, where people either hear what they want to hear, or they hear the thing that supports their worldview, let's put it that way. But it can also be just completely fabricated. People can, I mean, you know, a lot of history is just made up to make it sound good for one side or another of a dispute. And you have to keep in mind that the storytelling version of reality is often a lot more fun and interesting than the plain old, regular, untreated, plain text version of reality. So the inexactitude can be completely innocent. And what is the significance of all this is that we can go through life thinking, oh Lord, don't let me be misunderstood, and you're going to be misunderstood anyway because of that imprecision of the way people remember things. The world is riddled with amusing anecdotes about people who have been dead for hundreds or even thousands of years. And so people become stories in a way, whether they like it or not. And, you know, the reality that they really were is probably more boring than the stories that come down to us. I think this is a good argument for writing stuff down and saving all your emails. But I guess we just have to get used to the fact that we're going to be misunderstood. We're going to be misremembered, and people are going to think we said things we didn't say. That's kind of unfortunate, but I think it's true. And that's all I had to say about that. Maybe you have something to say about that. If so, put it there. I'm at sdcollins@postwar.nl. I always like to hear from you guys. Something strange happened today, by the way. It snowed in Amsterdam. It doesn't happen very often. I think about this much snow on the ground, which is pretty scary. I can't believe it. I walked out there, you know, I left a cup of coffee outside last night. When I went out, I didn't just have iced coffee. I had ice coffee. So I made a liquid version when I got back in the house. Oh, that's pretty hot. It's quite possible that I will see you again next week. In the meantime, I hope that you and all those snowflakes behind you will have a feine Abend verder.